Hello everyone, this video is in continuation to our videos on animal kingdom. We have discussed nervous system and skeletal system in our last video. In this video, we'll talk about reproductive system and body temperature. Fine, so we'll talk about how different organisms are categorized on the basis of different types of reproductive and body temperature characteristics. Now, when we talk about reproductive system, on the basis of reproduction, the organisms are basically categorized into two main categories, asexual and sexual. The organisms which undergo sexual reproduction and the ones which undergo asexual reproduction. When we talk about asexual, there can be budding, we have multiple types, there can be binary fission, multiple fission, so and so forth. These are the types of asexual reproduction. When we talk about sexual reproduction organisms which undergo sexual reproduction shows two main features. One is, one, they show sexual dimorphism. Sexual dimorphism is that separate males and females, they show different secondary sexual characters. They can be easily identified as male and female, and they undergo sexual reproduction. The second category, which the characteristic which is shown by the organisms, is the they can show sexual dimorphism. Where they have a male and a female. They are hermaphrodites also. Hermaphrodites are the ones which have, or you can say, one organism has both male and female part. Now, these organisms, they also show sexual reproduction. How? Because these hermaphrodites, they show sexual reproduction because they undergo, or a few of them, they undergo two main stages. One is known as protogynous, and one is known as protandrous. Protandrous condition, protogynous condition. Protandrous condition, where males mature first, then the female. That means the male part of that organism will mature first and female is still immature. So there cannot be, you know, reproduction between the same organism. It has to undergo mating or sexual, it has to undergo reproduction with some other organism wherein the female part is mature. So this is a protandrous condition. When we talk about protogynous condition, the condition wherein the female part mature first. So when the female part mature first, the male part is not mature. So there also they have to undergo sexual reproduction with some other organism. So that means hermaphrodites can also undergo the organisms which have both the male and female part in the same organism, like earthworm. They can also undergo sexual reproduction. How? Because in some conditions they are protandrous, and in other conditions they are protogynous. Wherein in protandrous condition, we can give example of earthworm and leech. In earthworm and leech, both the scenarios, the male part, it develops first and then the female part. So they have to undergo sexual reproduction. Whereas in protogynous, we talk about herdomania, wherein the female part, it matures first and then the male part. Now, after this, we have talked about sexual reproduction, the two main organisms on the basis of sexual dimorphism, male and female separate, hermaphrodite, wherein one organism has both the parts. Now, on the basis of fertilization, that also comes under reproduction. So, we'll be talking about fertilization. The organisms can be categorized on the basis of fertilization. They show two types of organisms. They show two types, internal fertilization and external fertilization. Internal fertilization is the one wherein the embryo or the baby develops in the body of the female, inside the body of female, example in the human beings. External fertilization is the one wherein development takes place outside the body. For example, frogs and fishes, they lay eggs and the sperms, the male pours the sperm over the eggs and they get fertilized outside the body of the female. So herein we give the example of, humans, and here fish, frogs are the example. Then after fertilization, what happens? Development. How does the development of the organism take place? Development. On the basis of development, they are also categorized into two types. The ones who show direct development and the ones which show indirect development. Direct and indirect. Direct development is wherein a full grown replica is produced. For example, in humans, they give rise to a baby human having ear, nose, eyes, every part is same, but yes, it grows in size after that. So it's a human full grown. Same goes in birds also. The egg hatches to produce a similar young one. Wherein in case of indirect development, what happens? The organisms undergo metamorphism, as in the egg is laid and then it hatches into a larva, then pupa, then a small tadpole, and then finally the frog. So they undergo metamorphisms. That is the indirect type of development. Now this metamorphism is also of two types, progressive and retrogressive. What is progressive metamorphism? Progressive metamorphism is when in the organism which is formed, it is lacking in a few parts and it develops those parts when it forms a new organism, a whole organism. Then it develops a few parts and finally form a new big sized organism. Whereas retrogressive is the one wherein the organism degenerates. That means, for example, when we talk about frog, the tadpole is there. Now tadpole is an advanced stage. It has gills, it has tail, but when it transforms into a frog, it loses those gills, lungs are formed, and tail is also reduced, and tail is also not formed. In retrogressive, a few of the characteristics are lost, whereas in progressive, the organism gains in a few new advanced structures which are there in the fully developed organism. Fine. So we have discussed reproduction on the basis of sexual, asexual, then fertilization, internal, external, development, direct and indirect development. Then we'll talk about body temperature. It's a very small topic. I'll just write it here. Now, when we talk about body temperature, there are two main types of organisms on the basis of body temperatures. We all know cold-blooded, warm-blooded. The term given to them are homeothermals. Homeothermals and poikilothermals. Okay, poikilothermals, homeothermals are the ones which are warm-blooded. We call it warm-blooded. Whereas poikilo are cold-blooded. Fine. So the warm-blooded, we are warm-blooded. Humans are warm-blooded. I'll just explain you how. Warm-blooded and cold-blooded. One, we humans are warm-blooded. Now, what happens? We have a normal body temperature and optimum body temperature. Bahar ka temperature either rises or falls. Our body temperature is not affected by it. That means our body can itself maintain its body temperature. So our body has a mechanism to, to stop or so that there is no fluctuation of body temperature according to the outside body temperature. So they are warm-blooded organisms, wherein there are some organisms whose body temperature rises and falls according to the outside body temperature. Like, for example, alligators. They are cold-blooded, so what happens? Their body temperature, it falls when outside it's very cold outside. It rises when it's hot outside. You must have seen the alligators lying outside the pond with their mouth open so that they can take in the sun's heat and can raise their body's temperature. So what I mean to say is, warm-blooded are the ones wherein the body can maintain the body's temperature, whereas the cold-blooded are the ones wherein the body temperature fluctuates according to the outside body temperature. So these are the categorization of animal kingdom on the basis of reproduction and body temperature. So we are done with all the systems now. In our next video, we'll start with animal kingdom classification. So keep watching, liking, sharing, subscribing. Thank you.